Hello, in this video I shall be discussing five topics. The first topic is National Press Day. So in India we celebrate this National Press Day annually every year on a particular date of November 16th. So November 16th is chosen for National Press Day because this is the date on which Press Council of India started its working. So this is the reason behind the date, and this National Press Day reiterates on free and responsible press in India. So the press has to have freedom. So freedom of press is ensured, and freedom under freedom of speech and expression. So freedom of press is reiterated by National Press Day, and the press has also to be responsible to the public, as a public have good confidentiality on press. The press has to have responsibility towards the public. So this aspect is reiterated in National Press Day. To have something about PCI or Press Council of India, this is the highest authority and a watchdog on press. So that looks after the working of press. So this ensures that the press is having high standards in India and it's not falling short of standards, and that the press is working without any influence or threat from any external factor. So this is one assurance that PCI offers to press. So this is about National Press Day. The next topic is Tristan da Cunha. This is the name of a place. This place is the largest fully protected marine reserve so far. So this is a marine area that is fully protected now. It has entered into this fully protected stage, and this is also inhabited, and this is the largest of this kind, like fully protected marine reserve. So this is largest with an area of 6,87,000 square kilometers. This Tristan da Cunha is present in South Atlantic Ocean, and this is under the British. So this is a UK overseas territory. So this is far from British, far from Britain, that is in South Atlantic Ocean. So this is the UK overseas territory. This is designated as the most remote human settlement. So amongst all the human settlements on the globe, this is the most remote one, and this very few people know about this area, and most remote inhabited archipelago. So this is, however, inhabited, this is having human settlement, and this is an archipelago, that is, it has a group of islands have formed this Tristan da Cunha. So these islands, this archipelago is volcanic in nature. So remote volcanic islands these are. Though it is under the Britain, this has its own constitution, and this is famous for having millions of seabirds and land birds. So this is a very distinct feature of Tristan da Cunha, that is, it has millions of seabirds and land birds endemic to this area. The next topic is Hanoi Declaration. Hanoi Declaration is taken up in East Asia Summit 2020 that is held recently. So the declaration points are to have a regional architecture centered on ASEAN. ASEAN is Association of Southeast Asian Nations that has got 10 countries. So this group has got an architecture. So the same architecture must be followed even by East Asia countries that attend this East Asian Summit. So this is one point in the declaration. The next point is to reaffirm the previous declarations. East Asia Summit happened even earlier also, no? So those all declarations must be reaffirmed, like 2010 Hanoi Declaration, 2011 Bali Declaration, 2015 Kuala Lumpur Declaration. So these three declarations are reaffirmed again, that these are binding with these three declarations. All these countries are binding with these three declarations is what is again reaffirmed in 2020 East Asia Summit. Something about East Asia Summit, this has got East Asian countries, that is 18 member countries are present in this. There are 10 of them are ASEAN countries, those all that are in ASEAN, plus 8 other countries which are not in ASEAN. They are Australia, China, India, Japan, New Zealand, Russia, US and Republic of Korea. So these are the countries that are having their membership in East Asian Summit apart from these 10 ASEAN countries. So this is about Hanoi Declaration that is recently taken up in East Asia Summit. The next topic is Sur Sarovar Lake. Sur Sarovar Lake is present in Uttar Pradesh. This lake is in news because this is recently adopted into Ramsar sites. Ramsar sites is a recognition of wetlands, international recognition of all important wetlands is a Ramsar site. So Ramsar site is taken up as part of Ramsar Convention that took place in 1971 by UNESCO, United Nations Educational, Social, Cultural Organization. And this is an intergovernmental environmental treaty that took place between countries, and by this wetlands will be adopted into Ramsar sites and given special protection. This Ramsar site, this areas are called as Ramsar sites, and they are taken into effect from 1975. This particular lake has recently entered into this Ramsar site. This is also called as Keetham Lake, that took its origin from Kola Barrage that is built on River Yamuna from Delhi, and it receives water from Agra Canal. So this is some brief facts about the lake, and it has entered into Ramsar site, which gave this a great international recognition from India. The last topic for today is code on social security. So social security is something given to employees. There is a code for it which speaks about the rules of this social security. We shall see about that. So code on social security is about Ministry of Labour and Employment. As I've told, this is for employees. So now this is in use because the registration into this code of social security is going to give the registration under its purview even to unorganized workers, small workers, platform workers and gig workers. Gig workers are those that depend totally on online kind of booking things and all. So these gig workers, platform workers and unorganized workers, they all are also going to get social security to some extent. So this is the new addition into the code on social security by Ministry of Labour and Employment. These people, unorganized workers, gig workers, platform workers, they are going to have their registrations done by Aadhaar into central government portals. So they are now included into security. So earlier this social security code has got employees, State Insurance Corporation, National Social Security Board and Employees Provident Fund Organization. So all those employees that are covered under these areas, that are, you can say in a word, that organized workers, all those organized workers come under this social security, but now it is extended to unorganized platform workers and even gig workers, that these people are increasing these days in numbers. So in order to give them good security, social security is extended to this area, these people also. So this code is under Ministry of Labour and Employment. So these are all the five topics for today, and thank you.